11.3, name organic compounds. Please refer to table P, which gives prefixes based on the number of carbons in organic compounds, table Q, which gives names of hydrocarbons, and table R, which gives endings in functional groups. Let's introduce naming organic compounds. The format is a number plus the prefix plus the group for the side chain first, then the number plus the prefix plus the group for the main functional group last. Remember this format throughout the lesson. The two levels of difficulty for naming are hydrocarbons and simple functional groups, and to substitute hydrocarbons in functional groups. Let's discuss side chains in terms of prefixes and groups. Please memorize this slide. As just learned, the format for the side chain is number plus prefix plus group first and the name, which is shown in red. The number shows the locations of the side chains. The two possible prefixes, on the other hand, are di for two of the same side chain and tri for three of the same side chain. The possible side chain groups are shown here. Methyl or CH3, which is one carbon bonded to the three H's attached to the main chain. Ethyl or CH3CH2, which is one carbon bonded to three H's followed by one carbon bonded to two H's attached to the main chain. Propyl CH3CH2CH2, or one carbon bonded to three H's followed by one C bonded to two H's and another C bonded to another two H's attached to the main chain. And the four halides are the last four side chain groups. F or fluoro, Cl or chloro, Br or bromo, and I or iodo all attached to the main chain. All right, again, please remember these prefixes in side chain so that you can use them during the lesson. Now let's discuss main functional groups. You have to use tables P, Q, and R. The format for naming functional groups is number plus prefix plus group shown in blue, and it goes last in the name. All right, the number matches the locations where the functional group is. Prefixes match up to the number of carbons based in table P, including meth, eth, prop, etc. And the groups match up to hydrocarbons shown on table Q and to functional groups shown on table R. And the endings of the functional groups are given on both tables Q and R. Let's learn how to name organic compounds. The format is number plus prefix plus group for side chain in red, then number plus prefix plus group for main functional group in blue. All right, step one, you have to number the carbons left to right and right to left on the flat chain in the middle, or forwards and backwards. Step two, you have to write the lowest possible number, noting location of the main functional group, using one of the numbering systems from step one, whichever gives you the lowest possible number for the functional group. All right, then you have the prefix based on the number of carbons in the main group, which you can find on table P, then the group name ending based on tables Q and R. All right, and that's based on the functional group. The combination of these three goes last in the name of the organic compound. Step three, write the number noting locations of the side chain, and that's based on the numbering system chosen in step two. All right, then prefix based on how many times the side chain repeats, di or tri, di for two repeats, tri for three repeats. Then the side chain group name, which includes methyl, ethyl, propyl, fluoro, etc. The combination of these three goes first in the name for the side chains. Putting these two together, the first part plus the last part of the name give the whole name of the organic compound. All right, in addition to that, there are two special notes here that I want you to remember. First, note that you should always use the numbering system from step one forwards or backwards that makes the number of the functional group as low as possible. That's because the number of the functional group is always the priority. You always, always, always want to make the number of the functional group as low as possible before anything else. All right. The one exception is if the functional group has no number, such as in the case of alkanes, then you have to make the numbers of the side chains as low as possible instead using the numbering directions from step one. All right, so in any case, just remember that you always have to choose the numbering direction from step one forward or backward that makes the number of the functional group as low as possible first, because that's a priority. However, in the case that the functional group has no number, such as in the case of alkanes, you have to make the numbers of the side chains as low as possible instead. All right, let's start at level one, naming simple hydrocarbons and functional groups. Remember, format for the functional group is number for location plus prefix from table P plus group ending from tables Q and R. A, CH3, CH2, CHO. Step one, number C's in CH3, CH2, CHO forward and backwards. So 1, 2, 3, and 3, 2, 1. Step two, you have to identify the non-hydrocarbon functional group with the lowest number plus the prefix for the number of carbons plus the group ending. The functional group here is CHO. The lowest location or number is 1 because 1 is less than 3 here. So use the backward system 3, 2, 1 from step 1. All right? So the number is 1. The prefix is prop because you have three carbons here, and three carbons equals prop base in table P. And group ending is enal because CHO is the function group, and CHO equals an aldehyde, which has the ending enal base in table R. So the name is 1-propanal. B, we have this structure. Step 1 number C is in the flat chain forward, 1, 2, 3, 4, and backwards, 4, 3, 2, 1. Step 2, identify the functional group with the lowest number plus the prefix of the number of carbons plus the group ending. The functional group involves a double CC bond. All right, the lowest location or number is at 1 because 1 is less than 4. So you use the forward system 1, 2, 3, 4 from step 1. All right, the prefix is bute because you have 4 carbons and 4 Cs equals bute base in table P. And the group ending is ene because you have a double CC bond, and a double CC bond equals an alkene, which has the ending ene base in table Q. All right, so therefore the name is 1-butene. C, we have this structure. Number C is in the flat chain forward, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and backwards, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Step 2, identify the functional group with the lowest number plus the prefix of the number of carbons plus the group ending. The functional group is C double bonded to O. And the lowest location is 2 here because 2 here is less than 4, so you have to use the backwards system 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 from step 1. The prefix is pent because you have 5 C's, and 5 C's equals pent based on table P. And the group ending is a known because the functional group is C double bonded to O, and C double bonded to O equals ketone, which has the ending a known based in table R. So the name is 2-pentanone. D, we have this structure. Step 1 number C is in the flat chain forward, 1, 2, 3, 4, and backwards, 4, 3, 2, 1. Step 2, identify the functional group with the lowest number plus the prefix of the number of carbons plus the group ending. The functional group is OH. And the lowest location or number is 2 here because 2 is less than 3. So use the backward system 4, 3, 2, 1 from step 1. All right, the prefix is bute because you have 4 C's, and 4 C's equals bute based in table P. And the group ending is a null because the functional group is OH, and OH equals alcohol, which has the ending a null based in table R. So the name is 2-butanol. E, we have this structure. Step 1 number C is in the flat chain forward, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And backward, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Step 2, identify the functional group with the lowest number plus the prefix of the number of carbons plus the group ending. The functional group is COOH. The lowest location is 1 because 1 here is less than 5, so use the backward system 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 from step 1. The prefix is pent because you have 5 C's, and 5 C's equals pent based in table P. The group ending is anoic acid because COOH is a functional group, and COOH equals an organic acid, which has the ending anoic acid based on table R. So the name is 1-pentanoic acid. F, we have this structure. Step 1 number C is in the flat chain forward, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and backwards, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Step 2, identify the functional group with the lowest number plus the prefix for the number of carbons plus the group ending. The functional group involves a triple CC bond here, and the lowest location or number where it starts is at 3 because 3 is less than 5 here, so you use the forward system 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 from step 1. The prefix is hept because you have 7 carbons on the flat chain, and 7 C's equals hept base on table P. And the group ending is YNE because you have a triple CC bond, and a triple CC bond equals an alkyne, which has the ending YNE base on table Q. So the name is 3-heptine. Now let's discuss level 2, naming substituted hydrocarbons and functional groups. The format is number for location plus prefix diatri plus side chain group ending methyl, ethyl, propyl, fluoro, etc. for the side chain here. Then you have number for location plus prefix from table P plus group ending from tables Q and R, all for the functional group in blue. All right, so let's try this with some examples. Example A, we have this structure. Step 1, you have to number the carbons in the flat chain forward, 1, 2, 3, 4, and backwards, 4, 3, 2, 1. Step 2, you have to identify the functional group with the lowest number plus the prefix for the number of carbons plus the group ending. As you can see, there are all single carbon-carbon bonds everywhere. So because there are all single carbon-carbon bonds everywhere, there's actually no location. So you actually leave out the number here for the functional group completely. All right, the prefix, however, is bute because you have 4 carbons here, and 4 C's, as you know, equals bute based in table P. The group itself is, the group ending itself is ane because all single carbon-carbon bonds in the structure means it's an alkane, which has the ending ane based on table Q. So the last part of the name would be butane. 4 carbons and all single carbon-carbon bonds, so it's butane. Step 3, identify the side chains with the number plus the prefix plus the group. The side chain here, as you can see, is F. And note very specifically that the functional group itself had no number because it's an alkane. So what you need to do instead is make the side chain numbers as low as possible instead. All right? So the lowest number location for F is 2 here because 2 is less than 3. So you use the forward system 1, 2, 3, 4 from step 1. All right, so the number is 2. There's no prefix because F only appears once. So you use no prefix. You only use a prefix if you have it repeating more than once. But since it only appears once here, F has no prefix, so it's just no prefix. And the side chain itself is fluoro because F equals fluoro based on table R. So therefore, if you put that together, you get 2 and fluoro for the first part of the name, 2-fluoro. All right, the whole name putting the first and last parts together is 2-fluorobutane. All right, in B, we have the structure. Step 1, you have to number the carbons and the flat chain forward and backwards. So we go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Step 2, you have to identify the functional group with the lowest number plus the prefix plus the group. Note that the functional group here is all single carbon-carbon bonds in the flat chain. And since single carbon-carbon bonds are everywhere, there's actually no location. So you actually leave the number out completely again for the functional group since it's all alkanes and single carbon-carbon bonds. All right, so you leave out the number completely because it's an alkane. The prefix, however, is pent because you have 5 carbons on the flat main chain in the middle here. And 5Cs, as you know, equals pent based in table P. The group ending is ane, because you have all single carbon-carbon bonds in the flat chain, and all single carbon-carbon bonds, as you know, is an alkane, which has the ending ANE based on table Q. So these two put together is pentane for the last part of the name. Step 3, you have to identify the side chains with the number plus the prefix plus the group. The side chain, as you can see here, is CH3 coming off of the main chain. And note that the original functional group had no number because it was an alkane. So what you need to do now, based on the rules, is you have to make the side chain here, you have to make the number of the side chain here for CH3 as low as possible instead. And the lowest number location for the side chain CH3 is 2 because 2 is less than 4 based on these numbering systems. So you have to therefore use the forward system 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 from step 1. All right? So the number would be 2 for the CH3 since that's the lowest number. So the number is 2. You have no prefix because CH3 only appears once here. So you just leave out the prefix. And the functional group itself, CH3, is known as methyl, since you should know that by now. All right. So therefore, if you put those two pieces of information together, you get 2-methyl for the first part of the name. So if you put this first part of the name with this last part of the name, you get 2-methylpentane. All right, C, we have this structure. Step 1, you have to number the C's in the flat chain forwards and backwards. So you go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay? Step 2, you have to identify the functional group with the lowest number plus the prefix for the number of carbons plus the group ending. The functional group, as you can see here, is OH. Okay? The lowest number location of OH is 3 because 3 is less than 4 here. So you use the backward system 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 from step 1. All right, so therefore the number for the functional group is 3. The prefix is hex because you have 6 carbons here, and 6 carbons, as you know, equals hex based in table P. The group ending is a null because you have OH which in, as a function group, which gives you an alcohol, which has the ending a null based in table R. So put these three together, and you get 3-hexanol for the last part of the name. All right, step 3, you have to identify the side chain with number plus prefix plus group. The side chain here is CH3. All right, and in step 2, note that we use the backward system 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 to locate OH at 3, so you have to use the same numbering system for locating the CH3 side chain. Okay, remember that the functional group's numbers always takes priority over anything else. So based on the system, the CH3 number is at location 5 since you're using this number system on the bottom. All right, so the number is 5. There's no prefix because CH3 only appears once. And the side chain itself, CH3, is known as methyl, which you should know by now. So put those two pieces of information together and you get 5-methyl. All right, so put this first part of the name 5-methyl with this last part of the name 3-hexanol and you get 5-methyl-3-hexanol. All right, please watch the next part of this video lesson for more examples of level 2 and some sample problems. Thank you very much. Let's continue on with part two of 11.3a. In D, we have this structure. Step one, you have to number the carbons in the flat chain forward and backwards. So you go 1, 2, 3, 4, and 4, 3, 2, 1. All right. Step two, you have to identify the functional group of the lowest number plus the prefix plus the group. The functional group here is OH. And the lowest number location of OH here is 2 because 2 is less than 3. So you use the forward system 1, 2, 3, 4 from step 1. All right, so the number is 2 for the functional group. The prefix is bute because you have 4 carbons in the flat chain, and 4 carbons, as you know, equals bute based in table P, so the prefix is bute. The group ending is enol because OH is your functional group, and OH, as you know, matches up to an alcohol, which has the ending enol based in table R. All right? So that's your ending enol. So if you put these three pieces of information together, you get 2-butanol for the last part of the name. Okay? Step three, you have to identify the side chains with the number plus the prefix plus the group. The side chains are 2CH3s here and here. And note that in step two, we use the forward numbering system 1, 2, 3, 4 to locate the OH at 2. So we had to locate the 2CH3 side chains using the same numbering system. Remember that functional groups numbers always take priority over anything else. Based on this numbering system, forward 1, 2, 3, 4, CH3's numbers are on carbons 1 here and 2 here. So the numbers are 1 and 2 for the side chains CH3 and CH3. The prefix for the side chains are di, because CH3 appears twice here and here. So you use di since it appears twice. The side chains themselves are called methyl because these two CH3s each match up to the name methyl, which you should know by now. So if you put these three pieces of information together, the name for the side chain is 1,2-dimethyl. Okay? So if you put the first part of the name 1,2-dimethyl with the last part of the name 2-butanol, you get the full name is 1,2-dimethyl-2-butanol. Okay? So there you go. In E, we have this structure. So step one, you need to number the C's in the flat chain forwards and backwards. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 forwards, and 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 backwards. Step two, you have to identify the functional group with the lowest number plus the prefix plus the group. You have all single carbon-carbon bonds here. So there's no actual location since the single carbon-carbon bonds for the functional group are everywhere. So you actually leave the number out for the functional group because it's everywhere. Okay? And the prefix, however, in the flat chain is hept because you have 7 carbons. And 7 carbons, as you know, is equal to hept based in table P. The group ending itself is ane because single carbon-carbon bonds matches up to an alkane, which is the ending ane based in table Q. So therefore, if you put those two pieces of information together, the first part of the name is heptane. Step three, you have to identify the side chains with the number plus the prefix plus the group. The side chains are 2Cls here and here. And note that the functional group itself in step two had no number, so you have to instead make the side chain numbers as low as possible. The lowest number locations for these 2Cls are 3 and 4 because 3 is less than 5. So you use the forward system 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Therefore, the numbers for the CL side chains are 3, 4. The prefix is di because you have 2Cl, so therefore, since you have 2 of the same thing, 2Cls, you use di because you have 2 of the same side chain Cl. And the side chain group itself, Cl, is chloro because Cl stands for chloro based on table R. So if you put these three pieces of information together, you get 3,4-dichloro for the first part of the name. So if you pair this first part of the name, 3,4-dichloro, with the last part of the name, heptane, you get 3,4-dichloroheptane. Okay? In F, we have the structure. Step one, you have to number the C's forward and backwards. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Step two, you have to identify the functional group with the lowest number plus the prefix plus the group. But what you notice is that you have all single carbon-carbon bonds here for the main chain everywhere, so there's no actual location because it's an alkane and all the CC single CC bonds are everywhere. So you actually leave out the number for the functional group. The prefix is hex, however, because you have 6 carbons on the main chain, and 6 carbons, as you know, matches up to hex based on table P. The group ending is ane because
You have all single carbon-carbon bonds, and all single carbon-carbon bonds, as you know, is alkanes, which matched up to the ending ANE, based on table Q. Okay, so the first part of the name here is hexane. In step three, you have to identify the side chains with the number plus the prefix plus the group. The side chains are two CH3s here and here. And note that the functional group in step two had no numbers, so you have to make the side chains numbers for these two CH3s as low as possible instead. The lowest number locations for CH3s are 2 here and 3 here because 2 is less than 5 and 3 is less than 4. So therefore, you have to use the forward numbering system 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. All right, so the numbers for the CH3s are 2 and 3 based on this forward numbering system. So the numbers are 2, 3 for the two CH3s. All right, the prefix is di for these two CH3s because you have two of the same side chain CH3 here and CH3 here, so the prefix is di. The side chain itself, CH3, is known as methyl because CH3 is equivalent to methyl, which you should know by now. So the side chain group name is actually methyl. So if you put those three pieces of information together, the first part of the organic compound name is 2,3-dimethyl. If you combine this first part of the organic compound name 2,3-dimethyl with this last part of the organic compound name hexane, you get 2,3-dimethylhexane. Okay? In G, we have the structure. Step one, you have to number the C's forward and backwards on the flat chain. So you get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 for the forward direction, and 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 for the backwards direction. Step two, you have to identify the functional group of the lowest number plus the prefix plus the group. The functional group itself is OH, as you can see here. And the lowest number location of OH is 2 because 2 is less than 5. So you use the forward numbering system 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 from step 1. Therefore, the number of the functional group is 2. The prefix is hex because you have 6 carbons in the flat chain, and 6 carbons, as you know, matches up to hex based in table P. So the prefix is hex. The group ending is a null, and the reason for that is because OH is the functional group and OH matches up to an alcohol. And alcohols have the ending a null based in table R. Okay? So putting these three pieces of information together, you get the last part of the name is 2-hexanol. Step three, you have to identify the side chains using the number plus the prefix plus the group. The side chains are three CH3s here, here, and here. And note that in step two, we use the forward numbering system 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 to locate the OH at position 2. So you have to locate the CH3 side chains with the same numbering system 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 in the forward direction. Remember that the functional group's numbers always take priority. So based on this, CH3's numbers are at carbons 1, 2, and 3. So the numbers are 1, 2, and 3 for the side chains CH3, CH3, and CH3. The prefix is tri because you have CH3 repeating three times here, here, and here. So the prefix is tri. The functional group side chain itself is methyl because CH3 equals methyl, as you should know by now. So putting those three pieces of information together, you get the first part of the name is 1, 2, 3 trimethyl. So if you put this first part of the name 1, 2, 3 trimethyl with this last part of the name 2-hexanol, you get the name is 1, 2, 3 trimethyl 2-hexanol. Here are some sample problems that you can try on your own and that you can check your answers with. I'm going to explain it in a minute, but right now I want you to stop the video before you move on and try these on your own by covering up the answers and see if you get the answers right when I'm going over these answers, okay? So stop the video at this moment, please. So now let's go over the answers. For 1A, this should be named 1-hexanol. The reason for this is because, first of all, the functional group is COH. And COH is located at the lowest possible number location of 1 here. If you number it backwards, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, so then the lowest possible number location for COH, or CHO rather, is 1. It's hex because you have 6 carbons here in the flat chain, so 6 carbon stands for hex based in table P. And the ending is anal because CHO matches up to an aldehyde, which has the ending anal based in table R. For B, you should get 4-octanone. The reason for this is because the lowest possible location for C double bonded to O is 4 if you number it backwards, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. So the lowest possible number location for C double bonded to O is 4. It's oct because you have 8 C's in the flat chain, and 8 C's, as you know, matches up to the prefix oct based in table P. And
the ending is a known because you have C double bonded to O here, and C double bonded to O matches up to a ketone, which has the ending unknown based on table R. So it's 4-octanone. For C, you should have gotten 3-pentanol. The reason for this is because the lowest possible location number for OH is 3. If you number forwards or backwards, it doesn't matter. But the point is the lowest possible number location for this is 3. All right? It's pent because you have 5 carbons on the main chain and 5 C's, as you know, matches up to pent for the prefix based in table P. The ending is a null because based in table R, OH matches up to an alcohol, which has the ending a null. Alright, so you have 3-pentanol. Here you should have gotten 1-heptanoic acid because you have the COOH at the 1 position if you number it backwards, 7654321. It's hep because you have 7 carbons in the main chain, 7 carbons matched up to the prefix hept-based in table P. And the ending is anoic acid because you have COOH at position 1 and COOH matches up to an organic acid, which has the ending anoic acid, based in table R. For E, you should have gotten 1-hexane. The reason for this is because the lowest possible number location where the triple bond starts is at 1 if you number it backwards, 654321. It's hex because there are 6 carbons on this flat main chain in the middle, and 6 carbons matched up to hex based in table P. And the ending is YNE because you have a triple bond and a triple bond in a hydrocarbon matches up to an alkyne, which is the ending Y and E based in table Q. So you have 1-hexane. For this is 2-butyne because you have C at the lowest possible location, 2 here. If you number it forwards, 1, 2, 3, 4. So the lowest possible location is 2 for where the triple bond starts. It's bute because you have 4 carbons and 4 C's matched up to bute for the prefix on table P. Alright? And the ending is Y and E because you have a triple bond, and a triple bond and a hydrocarbon matches up to an alkyne, which has the ending Y and E based in table Q. So the name is 2-butyne. For 1G, the name is 3-octene. The reason for this is because the lowest possible location for where the double bond starts in this hydrocarbon is at 3 if you number it backwards, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. So the lowest possible location is 3. It's oct because you have 8 carbons in the main flat chain in the middle. So it's oct, based on table P. And the ending is ene because you have a double bond here, and a double bond here matches up to an alkene for a hydrocarbon, which has the ending ene based on table Q. Alright, so the ending is ene. So you have 3-octene for this whole thing. 2A, the name is 3-bromohexane. Start with the main functional group, all single CC bonds. Single CC bonds means no number in the front for the main functional group. The prefix is hex because you have 6 carbons in the main flat chain, which equals the prefix hex using table P. And the group ending is ANE because all single carbon-carbon bonds means an alkane with the ending ANE using table Q. Alright, so that's the name for the main functional group, hexane. Because the functional group has no number, number the side chain, BR using the lowest number instead. So number backwards, and you get 3 for BR using the system 654321. Alright, so the number is 3. There's no prefix because BR only appears once, and BR, as you know, stands for bromo. So putting this together, you get 3-bromohexane. Alright, 2B is 4-ethyl-3-heptanol. Start with the main functional group OH, and OH is located at 3 as the lowest number if you use the backward system 7654321. And so therefore the number is 3. 7 carbons equals the prefix hept using table P, so the prefix is hept, and the ending is anol because OH here matches up to an alcohol, which is the ending anol using table R. So the functional group is 3-heptanol. The side chain is CH3CH2, and since you use 7654321 backwards to locate the OH at 3, use the same system to locate the CH3CH2. Based on the system, the location is 4 for CH3CH2. Alright, so the number is 4, and CH3CH2 only appears once, so there's no prefix. And as you know, CH3CH2 is ethyl, which you should know by now. Alright, so put that there. So the whole name together is 4-ethyl-3-heptanol. For C, use the same steps as 2A, but the answer is 3-methylhexane. For D, it's 1,4-dimethyloctane. The reason for octane is because you have 8 carbons in all single carbon-carbon bonds, so it's octane. 1,4-dimethyl because you have 2 CH3s repeating at 1 and 4, so it's 1,4-dimethyl, so 1,4-dimethyloctane. 1,3-dimethyl 4-octanol for E. The reason for 4-octanol is because you have 8 carbons, and you have an OH at 4, so it's 4-octanol. The reason for 1,3-dimethyl is because you have two CH3s repeating at 1 and 3, so it's 1,3-dimethyl, so 1,3-dimethyl-4-octanol. For F, you have 1,2,4-trifluoroheptane. The reason for heptane is because you have 7 carbons and all single carbon-carbon bonds, so you name it heptane. the reason for 1, 2, 4, 4 trifluoro is because you have 3 Fs repeating at 1, 2, and 4. So the name is 1, 2, 4 trifluoroheptane. Please complete these homework questions on your own.